press conference for the second season of DDFL. Before we begin, we'd like to thank God for this privilege. We'd like to thank Nalini Ghosh, NLTV, Express, and our official media partners on NLTV. We'll call three representatives from each team. I'd like to call upon Team Philippe and Team Unity on stage.
Okay, Unity Sporting Club, we finished in the sixth place last year. So this year, Unity Sporting Club basically was formed to promote our quality youth, our village youth. So last year we gave preference to, most of the preference was given to our village players. But this year we are hoping that with some help from other players, which we have already signed, we are hoping that this year we'll get a better result.
So basically, Telefe FC is a new club that is joining this competition this season. Our team was formed as basically we took the initiative to obviously boost and give recognition to of sports and of our village, Telefe village. And formation of players, I mean, our team consists of very young, talented players who have very high potential, and we also have hired some guest players who are very experienced. So we believe that with this mixture, with this balance, that it helps one another, and we believe that we have a good team and we can do good in the league.
Regarding this other player you are hiring to play in your team, are you guys going to pay them or just free? Other players you are hiring?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
For that too, before talk to you, whenever any player get the opportunity, we used to play for free, but then the season, the trend has changed. And then since many budding footballers are there, to motivate them and to encourage them, it's since other teams are also buying them, we are also buying some few. Not much, but just.
I believe the process of hiring players is, some football players, it's their profession, it's their earning. So we have to actually pay them because that's what they earn from. So if it's okay.
This season, first prize will be 2 lakhs and second will be 1 lakh. We have any more questions for the team? If not, we'll call them next team. We'll go ahead. Next team. Thank you so much for the time. We'd like to call upon Team Kushayu FC and 110 FC. Rolling Green FC. So Kushayu played last year. They were the team that took part last season. And one team is a new season, a new team for this season. 110 FC is a new team and Kushayu played last season. Previous tournaments, where the Mokko District Association hosted, and they are a new team for this season. And Kushayu is a new team, is a team that took part in last season's tournament.
expectations for this year?
Yeah, the preparations, it's a good, and we're hoping for the best, because last season we finished last, so like this season, you know, we're trying to we're trying our best for my sake, you know, so yeah, let's see what happens.
Your club representatives, captain's management. So basically all the teams are using their local grounds and they have their own home teams in their own colonies. So the last year's finalist team check in and same finalist like they are.
This year, compared to last season, we are signing a lot of new players also. So hopefully, our aim is to win the league this time since we were the runners up last season. So with the experience of the new players and that we are brought in, hopefully we can compete finally.
We started practicing since last month.
Hello.
A brief on both teams. Teams in Bakroma team will be playing in GDC Stadium. and one of the representatives are also Association of Mapo District Football Associations. And Team Gurur will be playing in your home ground, Team Gurur will be one. They played classes in as well, and Puma game is a new game. Any questions for Team Bipuro and Purmaki?
What are your prospects of this league? Do you think it should continue? And do you want it to be more statewide event league? How is it going?
Hello. Yeah, I believe the future is good in this league and prospects. That's because right now they're giving a platform for all the youngsters to play and perform. So from this light, most of them have a livelihood making money from this. So they're getting a platform to perform their talents. The performances, if they play good, they'll be hired by other clubs from outside. So it's good. So I believe if they keep on continuing this, it will grow automatically. Just they have to trust the process and keep faith. That's it.
Sponsor Asi or Colony Ravi, any motor to do this.
Thank you, Kim, the Burasi and Rogan. Would you like to go ahead to the next team? Jumu and Urak La Colony. skating park, both team skating park will be a, they have a new addition on the sea, on the lake. Team Chumu, the home ground will be in Chumurima Public Ground, and Team Urak will play in the city ground.
Yes, we are hiring players.
Managing a team, being the owner of a team, it takes a lot, like it's very expensive, like starting from the jersey and also hiring players, it costs a lot, and we get a few sponsors, but the sponsors cannot sponsor the team every season. So Dimapur district lake, like is like all the colonies are being represented. So if the colony itself helps the club, then I think the teams can sustain. But if the colony doesn't cooperate or give financial assistance, then I think it is very difficult for the team to go ahead. And also government, as of now there is no support. I believe that none of the team got the support from the government. It is all individually done, just for the love of the game, trying to help the young players. Thank you.
The UAVYO has been formed in the year 2011, and then this is not a new organization. Since 2011, as the UAVYO is formed, until now we have been organizing tournament in our area, which consists of 13 villages with 5 major tribes, including the Nepali. That is Angami, Chagasang, Sema, and Sangtang, and then including Nepali. We have 13 villages which we have been formed in the year 2011, and then since 2011 we have been organizing and playing this tournament. And then yesterday we have completed our tournament, and then you know, like we have been organizing this tournament, but we could not give a bigger platform to our area players and all. That's why like this is our first time participating in this DDFL, and then in order to give a bigger platform to our area players who are really interested in playing football, that's why yesterday we have selected the best players from 13 villages, and then today we are here. And of course, we are happy that we will be given opportunity to our players in a bigger platform. And then from our side, we have no any like sponsorship and all, but then from our official sites, we have been trying our best, and then in order to promote our players from our areas. Thank you. You see this, every year we have been organizing the tournament. So like this year, since Monday, we have already started and then completed yesterday itself. So from the tournament, we have been observing, and then there are selection team as well as, and then from there we have selected the best players from every village. So I think it's not late for us.
I'm removing the boom, okay?